as the countdown for 2019 election begins, the Modi government is likely to go as per tradition and present a vote on account in 2019 instead of a full-fledged budget. Sapna Das joins us with more details. Sapna, tell us, what are you picking up?
Well, we are clearly given to understand that most likely it's going to be a vote on account. That's what the government seems to be preparing for as per convention. And the convention always has been that it's an interim budget or a vote on account in an election year. Having said that, what this would really mean is that the government will seek the parliament's nod for 4 months of expenditure, April, May, June, July, for the new financial year. Although the revenue and the expenditure estimates are always done for the full fiscal. So that does not change. But what changes is the appropriation bill will be for 4 months, which will allow the government to seek the parliament's nod to, you know, draw the funds from the Consolidated Fund of India and do the expenditure for 4 months till a full government or a new government comes into place. Having said that, the other thing we need to keep in mind is that in terms of new announcements or any future roadmap for reform, that's completely a political call. But nothing prevents the government from, you know, announcing schemes, and it's not necessary that you have to come out with an immediate expenditure outlay for that. For example, the Ayushman Bharat can be can be kept in mind. The announcement came in this financial year in the finance minister's budget speech, but it took some time for the government to kind of, you know, explain the expenditure outlay, and even that has not been fully outlined so far in the current year's budget. So something may come forward on that front. So that's an example that I'm just giving. So nothing prevents the government from making these announcements, but that's again a political call. Last but not the least, no direct tax changes. What the finance bill will basically seek is a continuation of the existing direct tax laws, so no changes there. Continuation till the full budget is presented sometime in July. And last but not the least, also in terms of your indirect tax changes, well, they can be done at any point in time, but it's only the customs part which remains purely with the central government. The rest of the things have been given over to the GST Council.
Well, the Petroleum and Explosive Safety Organization has increased the pilot projects for home delivery of diesel. Anshu Sharma brings us all those details.
In April 2017, Oil Minister Dharmendra Pradhan had said that government is looking at options to deliver diesel at doorstep. More than a year after, three pilot projects are being run by OMCs or oil marketing companies such as IOC, BPCL, HPCL in cities like Pune, Rewari and Navi Mumbai. Now, CNBC TV 18 learns that Petroleum and Explosive Safety Organization, which is also called PESO, has doubled the license for door-to-doorstep delivery of diesel from 24 to 50. Now, government is not happy with the oil marketing companies as the OMCs are yet to submit a proposal on a full rollout of the scheme. Government is eager to expedite the full rollout of diesel home delivery, which will initially target high-consuming diesel dependents like shopping malls, genset owners and transportation businesses. Now, government mulls that a business plan must come into effect where dealers get a license from OMCs for delivery of diesel. Similarly, startups can also be given a license from the OMCs after all approvals are in place. Even private fuel retailers like RIL, Nayara Energy are eager to participate in the business of doorstep delivery of diesel. Though as of now, delivery of diesel seems a distant dream unless a business plan is in place for future investments. Back to you.